Big ups to Raycon for sponsoring this video, and also big ups on the people over at Raycon for making earbuds that stay in my ears when I dance around my apartment and sleep. You guys are the real goat. More on that a little bit later. Over the past couple months, years, and decades that I have been online, I have gotten a lot of requests to cover a lot of different people. I have been sent countless emails from people telling me to make videos exposing their parents, to talking about their high school bullies, to just plain talking about creators who I am friendly with that they don't like. In fact, the amount of emails I got from people, quote, warning me about Shauna Ray, despite the fact that she is nothing but a pure, kind-hearted woman who makes well-researched content and also lived in San Jose close to me, was insane. Especially all of the accusations that were leveled towards her were complete lies, but that is a video for another day. I get video requests often, and usually they are for petty things, or things that I am not super interested in covering. So I will shoot back a small response, thanking the person for their time in messaging me and letting them know that I'm not interested. But sometimes, very rarely, sometimes there are messages that are so intriguing, that talk about things that are so batshit insane that I have to stop and take a look. And this is one of those cases. Like, just the fact that there are DeviantArt journals and stash folders with evidence that show this person blatantly tracing over other people's work, trying to sell it since 2011, almost 10 years ago. That to me is peak ridiculous. So with that in mind, guys, buckle up, because today we're talking about NAD6969, the biggest art thief to ever be on DeviantArt. Hey guys, it's Shannon, and before I get started today, I do want to do my creator shout out for the video, and that goes to the amazing, amazing, amazing Stephanie Harlow. Stephanie has been making content for a while, and I found her when her channel was a beauty and makeup channel called Unapologetic Skincare and Beauty. And honestly, she is one of the most compelling creators out there. She is so fair and honest, and something about how she makes her videos is so completely calming to me. Honestly, kind of strange, because she talks a lot about psychopaths and deranged murderers. Like, her video on H.H. Holmes and the murder hotel is one of the things I fall asleep to nightly. I could probably recite that to you verbatim. But as calming as that is to me, it is about one of the first known serial killers who worked in ridiculous ways. So that gives you kind of an idea of what I fall asleep to. I promise I'm not insane. Stephanie has a beautiful, relaxing energy in all of her videos, and she does exude such amazing vibes that she almost feels like a friend rather than a person who I've never met before. And what's even crazier is that she told me that she also watches my videos, so sometimes she will tweet at me, and I honestly want to puke every time it happens because I feel so honored. Definitely go check her out if you love true crime content, and be prepared for deep dives into the minds of some of the worst individuals you have ever heard about. She frankly deserves all the love and support in the world, and she deserves so much more subscribers than she already has because of all the hard work and dedication she puts into her videos. Also, her merch is amazing. Go buy it. Now for the actual video. Like I said earlier, we are going to be talking about NADS6969, who is one of the most prolific art thieves to ever come out of DeviantArt, which makes a lot of sense to me because her name is literally NAD6969, which, let's be real here. Me saying that just totally got this video demonetized and probably removed me from the partner program. From this point on, I'm going to try to stop referring to her by her screen name, which is absolutely ridiculous, and just call her Nadia. However, I'm not really one to talk about bad screen names, seeing as I made an account on DeviantArt once that was fully based around my literal home address because I was an idiot child who really wanted to look up at all of Kiki Kun's artwork and was in an online relationship with someone named Sasuke Uchiha 666. So, not one to talk. Sorry about that, Nadia. But who exactly is Nadia? What does she do? What does she like? All that fun stuff. We need to dive deep into who this person is. Well, Nadia is a 38-year-old woman who lives in Canada and is obsessed with Sailor Moon. And when I say obsessed, I mean she's fully, completely, 100% obsessed with it. All of her art, quote, her art, is of Sailor Moon. All of her fans are from the Sailor Moon fandom, and straight up, this woman thinks loving Sailor Moon is a personality trait. And normally, we would love that for her. That's not a negative at all. That wouldn't be a negative normally, except for the fact that, again, she is a thief and has stolen the vast majority of her artwork and has actively used other people's work to gain a profit for herself, which is illegal. Just to show you what I'm talking about, here are a couple examples of her blatantly tracing over artwork over years from 2011 to 2020 and using other people's images as a base of sorts. And I say of sorts because sometimes she'll change things up, like maybe she'll flip the character, maybe she'll change the hair, maybe she'll change how the arm is posed. But straight up, she is still using their artwork and stealing it. Like, look at these images and tell me these aren't traced. Give me an argument. There is none. Look me in the eyes right now. You can't. Now, Now, something I really want to emphasize right now is how old Nadia is. Because usually when we see a case of art theft or people are making videos about that and we see someone stealing so brazenly, it's done by someone who is younger and someone who can say they didn't know any better. The last example I saw online of someone being exposed for a similar thing, the person accused was literally 13 and they just wanted to draw like their idols. So they were tracing it over and over and over again. Is it bad? Yes. But was it understandable because they didn't know any better and are 13? Yeah. But here we're talking about Nadia, and Nadia is 38. This is a whole ass grown ass adult who knows better than to do this, and who definitely knows that taking someone else's copyrighted artwork, which everything posted on DeviantArt has a copyright claim on it, tracing it and trying to redistribute it to make money and profit off of someone else's work. That's a big no. She is most definitely old enough to know that, and even if she didn't know it at first, back in 2011 when she was 27, she would have learned and known about it in any of the other countless times she has been called out for doing this over and over and over again on DeviantArt. Which, mind you, she has been called out a lot. Like, there are literal call-out pages that have documented every time someone has called her out, starting back in 2011. And the writer of the first one is someone by the name Wild Woodson. So with that in mind, let's read that first call-out post from 2011, when Nadia would have been 27, the age I am now, and what Wild Woodson thought of her. I really thought I could just delete the other journal and move on. Guess not. So this chica over here is mass producing images I drew back in 2004. She resizes the poses and reverses them and copies them and pastes them for a bit of flair here and there. At first, there was no credits on them, so I called her shit out. She was probably shitting herself, so she sicked her friends on me while pretending to be reasonable and making excuses. She says she found it on Google and doesn't remember the website. Last time I checked, you don't use someone's fan art you found on Google without at least trying to find out who drew it. So you can A, ask for permission, or B, find out who to credit. But God forbid she doesn't use shit that isn't hers, that she doesn't know who it belongs to. But it doesn't end there. I had requested she take the images down, and she did not respond. She blocked me and has continued to upload images made from my picture. She's added credit to older ones and credits me now on newer ones, finding an added way to bash me while doing so. And I cannot even retaliate. Watcher, I am not asking you to bash her. What I'm asking, fellow deviants, is to go to her page and leave a kind reminder that it is not okay to take things that do not belong to you, and ask her to remove what she did not ask for permission for and stop uploading copies. Be polite. We're better than being mean and snarky.
You know that moment where you have to remind a 27-year-old not to take things that isn't theirs and tell them that stealing is wrong? Relatable.
Now that is all that they wrote, and I will link the entire post in the description down below. By the way, I would have posted the images that they said were drawn over as evidence and shown the post. However, Nadia has since been taken off of DeviantArt. The posts were taken down, so I can't show them in context. So a lot of the context of this is not here, which is a bit lame, and I apologize for that. But good news, she was taken down, so it's good. Again, we're talking about Nadia, who, at the time, at the very least, was 27 years old, taking art that wasn't hers, tracing it over, and selling it on their platform. Not only that, she went out of her way to send her fans and friends to harass the original artist, who was very clearly not okay with this. Something that also sticks out to me is just how nice Wild Woodson is being here. Like, I don't know you, Wild Woodson, but you seem like the nicest peach in the pumpkin patch, because I would have been livid. I would have been so pissed. If someone had stolen and repurposed my art and sold it for a profit, I wouldn't have the decency to tell people, hey, don't be a dick. I would have literally been raining dicks onto that person, especially if they were older than me by a decade. But that's just me. I'm just a jerk. This post came out in 2011 and was straight up, Nadia was still active until December of 2019. And what do you think changed in those years? Do you think at some point this grown woman who has a literal child, do you think she learned from being called out in this post or any of the number of posts over the years? Do you think she stopped stealing from children and other artists using DeviantArt? The answer is no.
Of course not.
She kept tracing and stealing and abusing artistic copyright to the point where DeviantArt, after 13 years of her being active, finally kicked her off the platform. People were so invested in this, were so upset by her, that they wrote legitimate eulogies about this. People dedicated their entire Tumblrs and other social medias to inform people about this grown-ass 38-year-old woman, and straight up, they celebrated when she was finally kicked off. It was like Mardi Gras on DeviantArt. And just so you guys can get the scope of how absolutely butt-touching bonkers this woman was, let me read you the foreword from Envy Scorts Eulogy of Nad6969. Oh my god, I just forgot to call her Nadia. Put an F in the chat, boys. F in the comments right now, just for me. Actually, no. If you're still here, put a smiley face in the comment because I just want to be happy. I don't know. Anyway, to her eulogy. For the last 7 months or so, I joined the movement against the notorious Nad6969. If you've been living under a rock, Nad6969 was a middle-aged woman who loved Sailor Moon but couldn't draw worth a damn. So she traced damn near everything she had in her gallery. When confronted, she would either begrudgingly credit the artist for the work that she traced, or ignore entries to post credit and block the people asking her to be a decent human being. When faced with the choice to stop tracing or start crediting your shit, she chose the third option of continuing to be a talentless see you next Tuesday, keep tracing, and never credit. Here are her stats. Number of victims. This would be the number of people she stole from over the years. 150.
You heard that right, boys. She stole from 150 people. Let that sink in.
Numbers of years active, 13. Number of DMCA takedown notices, 11. Her list of offenses are rather extensive. Traced off other artists and didn't credit them. Sold trace works as commissions. Blocked artists who confronted her about her tracing their work and or asked them to credit them. Expected her watchers to find the original artist for her when she traced things. Attempted to sell her trace works on Redbubble after being asked by the original artist to not do this. Ignored several direct demands from Drakia Ranak to not trace his commissioned work. She's still doing it now. Produced a fake screenshot to make it look like Drakia Ranak gave her permission to trace his commissioned artwork. Attempted to pass off all trace artwork as her own in an art contest to win prizes. Initiated the Holocaust debacle, which is a whole other thing we're not going to talk about because if I say that word, I'm going to get demonetized. Refused to take down artwork of other people's original characters after they rescinded permission for her to use them after the Holocaust debacle. Upon being confronted by her commissioners about giving them trace work, she blocked them rather than refunding their points. Ban evaded the day after her formal ban. Currently continues to trace Drakia Ranak's commission artworks and posts them to her private Pinterest board. While I have tracked down a bunch of artists she is victimized, I also confronted the worthless admin Kite about her and demanded to know why she hasn't been banned yet. I got a bunch of non-answers and bullshit. It took someone politely but firmly threatening legal action against the CEO of DeviantArt to get action taken against her, even though DeviantArt's policy clearly states that after 3 DMCA notices, an account will be considered a repeat offender and will be banned without a chance to correct their behavior. Know that the total amount of DMCA takedown notices filed against her was again 11. So this grown-ass woman, who at the time was doing all this, she was 38 years old. This woman, who had a whole-ass living child, was out here stealing, lying about why she was stealing, profiting off numerous artists whose literal only crime was liking Sailor Moon. And she did this for 13 years. 13 entire years. If her online thievery was a real-life human person, their balls would have dropped and they would be experiencing acne for the first time. Like, she really potty-trained, taught the alphabet, sent to school, and watched her art thief of a son graduate middle school before her art thief son was taken off of line. And for what? Money? She didn't make that much, seeing as there's so many exposed posts about her and her comment section is literally filled with people calling her out. Like, so many people were dedicated to making sure nobody gave her money. It's absolutely insane. And what's worse is that in reality, nothing could be done about her actions. I know it sounds a bit bleak, but she was copying artwork that had watermarks, tracing work that had been safeguarded against art thieves, and it still happened. It's absolutely completely bonkers, and the fact that it took 13 whole years to get her offline is peak bananas. This woman is peak bananas, and while I'm not for deplatforming someone, when someone steals this much, when someone has a legacy that's this long, I say good riddance. Again, let me just put on screen right now some examples of the hundreds of examples of her stealing art. Like, literally, we know confirmed 150 people had their artwork stolen and sold by her. That's bananas. But you know what else is bananas? How amazing Raycon earbuds are. That was not my best transition. I know, I realized that, but still. Like I said before, this video is sponsored by Raycon. And as someone who loves music, trust me when I tell you these earbuds are amazing. When Raycon reached out to me, I first asked them before I signed my contract if I could get sent over a pair just to make sure I liked them before. And I have been using them ever since. First off, compared to all the other brands that I have ever used of any earbuds ever, the Raycon Everyday E25 earbuds are the best. I was not kidding when I talked about liking to listen to YouTubers like Stephanie Harlow when I go to bed. And these are the first earbuds to actually stay in my ears when I sleep, meaning I don't lose them and they're comfortable as heck. Not only that, but they're amazing to work out in and dance with and keep me from making too much noise when my husband, who is a musician and needs things quiet, is working. Straight up, their compact design is perfect and fits nicely into my ears, which is a big deal for me because iPhone headphones and other brands actually hurt me a lot, and if I keep them in for too long, it causes me headaches. So these don't do that, and I love them. Better yet, Raycons start at about half the price of other premium wireless earbuds. And they are better in pretty much every way. If you are interested in trying them out for yourself and seeing what all the hype is about, check my link in the description down below and get 15% off your order. That is 50% off your order when you use my link down there. That's a pretty stellar deal. I want to thank Raycon for sponsoring me and choosing to sponsor my channel. YouTube has gone through another mini adpocalypse behind the scenes, and though most people aren't talking about it, brands like Raycon reaching out to creators like me and supporting us directly is something that YouTubers really, really depend on. So please definitely do go give them love, thank them for what they are doing, and let me know what you think of Nadia, her years of art theft, and what's going on here. With that being said and done, thank you guys so much for watching, and I hope you have a stupendous day, and I will see you in my next video. Later!